We've all heard of the fat burning zone, that pace or level of intensity that promises to help you burn the most fat in a specific amount of time. In tonight's Fit for Life segment, the fitness nomad John Ashworth gives us his take on whether you can really transform your body using this method. Good to see you.
Good to see you, Lee.
So just to remind people, they've probably seen this, a lot of exercise equipment has this option that you can select to train on a specific program that's promising this fat burning result.
Yeah.
What does that program entail? Is it a slower pace than some of the others?
It's a slower pace because at lower intensities of exercise, even while you're sitting here, guess what? You're burning a greater proportion of fat for energy.
Okay.
So at about 60 to 70% of your max heart rate, you're burning mostly fat for energy.
So that's if you selected on a treadmill the fat burning one,
right.
It would have you right in that 60 to 70% range?
Exactly. It'll keep you at a lower intensity level.
Okay. Does it work?
Yes, but at higher intensity levels, you burn more total calories, so you burn more total fat.
Okay.
So yes, you're burning a greater proportion of fat for energy, but you still need to work harder.
So where should we be if we're talking these percentages?
Well, the 60 to 70% is good for a warm-up. It's good for parts of your exercise routine.
Okay.
But you've got to spend some time above the red line, baby. You've got to get
up there. Is that 85%?
85%, even 90%. So at that point where you can go hard, but you can only go for a minute, 2 minutes, and then you're so out of breath you have to come back down.
Now I want to clarify for people.
Mm-hmm.
Are you saying that if you work out at 85%, you're burning more fat when you work out than if you're working out at 60 to 70, or are you saying that's
yes.
going to translate later?
Both.
Both.
Both, because you're burning a greater proportion of calories when you're working harder. You're still burning more fat than when you're working at lower intensity levels.
So how do they get away with saying the fat-burning program?
Great question, Lee. I have no idea, and I've been trying to get that button off of those cardiovascular equipment for years now.
Good luck with that one. So afterburn is what you say is the key to success,
right.
And that's what we're talking about, the burning calories after
right.
you're done working out. Explain
right.
how that works and why that's important.
What most people don't think about is that everything that you do in the gym is important, but more important is how you recover and how hard it is for your body to recover. So the more you break yourself down during your workouts, the more calories you'll burn later in the day as you recover. So with strength training and high intensity interval type training, when you're doing your aerobic exercise, it takes more to recover, so you're going to burn a lot more calories throughout the rest of the day.
So this is why exercise is so important, because people who don't exercise, not only are they missing that 30 minutes to an hour of exercise,
right.
but then the whole day, they're not burning anything either.
Exactly.
So for instance, if you ran for half an hour, you would expect to burn what?
Well, now you're putting me on the spot.
I know.
But 20 to 30 calories per minute while you're running.
Okay.
And then how much more you're going to burn the rest of the day, that depends on a variety of factors, how much muscle tissue you have, how old you are, how fit you are, a lot of different factors, but you're definitely going to burn more later than the person who didn't work that hard or didn't exercise at all.
Right, so either if they were at the lower intensity or not doing anything.
Right.
It's a complicated thing, but we want to make sure everybody knows, because you don't want to do something and not get the results that you're hoping for, right? To read John's blog on dispelling the myth of that fat-burning zone, log on to our web channel and click on News Links. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Have a good weekend.
You too.
Get out and enjoy the weather.